What's going on, guys, and welcome back. MoveDex, the forgotten child of Marvel Snap. Now, for most of us, we really haven't played the archetype all that much. At most, you've been probably, like, bored, and you're like, I'll kick the tires on the move deck, let's see how it goes. And then you play Heimdall on 6, and you didn't do the math, we both know that, and then you lose. Or you drop, like, I don't know, 20 ranks, and then you delete the deck and call it a day. However, now, I can say with full confidence, the archetype is a lot easier to play and definitely competitive. I can tell you that my games last night with Ghost Spider, she definitely made a big difference. And each and every day, the archetype is going to get better and better as more players perfect move. Now, a few of these stood out much more than others in terms of performance and how easy they were to play. And today, I'll cover my favorite move decks of the bunch and how they operate. Now, all these decks are built a little bit different to accommodate the variants of different playstyles. And odds are, you're not going to be great with most of them. It's much different than the other decks out there. But if you're serious about playing move, well, then don't worry about your ring. Just get good with the deck and the combos and the win conditions. If you don't like a card, slot it out for another one. And, you know, as always, remember,
patience.
All right, guys. So first up, we have probably the easiest of the bunch to play. And I like to call it, I like the wave you move, or, you know, move wave is probably for short. And this is a very straightforward deck, guys. Once you know the basics of move, you're going to get this thing down easily. And we're just going to add in the sizzle of wave. Now, if you listen to the Snapchat that I had a couple of days ago, I talked endlessly before the season that Wave needs to be in move decks and that we're probably going to see a lot of people slot her in on the way to infinite, and we're already seeing it. Wave is a fantastic option to combine with move because of the ability to build up the power of your move cards while restricting your opponent, and you have Heimdall for that kind of final play at hand. Now, this deck's main focus is where you put your cards and the combos that you play on turns 3, 4, and 5. Obviously, playing Ghost Spider and Cloak alongside Wave is a fantastic combination for turn 5 going into turn 6. We're going to be looking to boost up our cards like Dagger and Vulture the most out of this deck, and you'll get consistent value out of Human Torch and Kraven as well. On turn 6, you'll have that option of Heimdall, but if things are looking great and all you need to do is play Arrow after Wave, then you have that option as well. Now, the next deck we're going to talk about, and I also think is in the borderline easy territory to operate as a move deck, is the Angela move deck. So this is a great deck with a lot of flexibility. You can have Nightcrawler and Kitty Pryde in here as well. But utilizing Jeff and Vision, you essentially make these a 2/5 and 5/9 power card in value because of Angela. And then combine that with building up our cards like Dagger, Vulture, and Human Torch. You have a lot of power kind of creeping out on the last turn of the game. Heimdall's a great option to throw on Angela as well, and you can get a surprising amount of power looking to win the left and middle location most of the time. I like to play Angela typically in the rightmost location and or middle depending on the locations you are given. A very consistent deck and just very straightforward deck, guys. You play your move cards not on Angela. You play the ones that can move like Jeff, Vision, or your low power cards like Iron Fist on Angela, and you're good to go. Now, next up, we have my boosted move deck, and this is the one that I prefer probably to play the most, at least the last couple of seasons, especially when I get to the Iron Lad variant. This can be tough to operate. There's a lot of moving pieces, no pun intended, and you want to avoid clogging your locations because things like multiple man, it's going to make it fairly easy to mess this deck up. But once you get the ropes down, you have Hulkbuster to boost up either Multiple Man and or Human Torch. And both of these cards are win conditions in themselves. You also have the Wave, Arrow, and Heimdall package, similar to the first deck that we talked about. So you already know the win condition for the final turns, and then you're looking to power up these other cards on the previous turn. I have to say, out of all the movable cards, Dagger and Vulture, obviously very good, but Multiple Man, do not sleep on this card, guys. He has some significant value in a lot of move decks, and he can get his power quite high, but this can happen even more so and more dependently, in my opinion at least, if you have Iron Lad and Howard Duck. Now, obviously, not a lot of people are going to have these cards. I wanted to include this deck, though, because this is the one that I played leading up to the season. This is the one that I still play a lot. Man, I got to tell you guys, getting Iron Lad value in Hulkbuster, getting Iron Lad for Heimdall early or as a move card or as Dagger Ghost, he finds value from so many cards. And if you can get Human Torch, you now have this card that can double up in power that can't be destroyed by Killmonger. All in all, both of the boosted move decks are really solid. Again, I would master the earlier, more basic movement decks and then move to this option. Iron Lad is fantastic. I think he gives you the potential to win more games if you snap with a good roll of Iron Lad. But at the same time, you know, he does add a bit more complexity. All right, now we're going to head into the final three decks, and these are going to be probably the harder versions to run just because the amount of decision-making and complexity. We have Silver Surfer move that has been common even outside of this season. A lot of great three-cost cards that happen to have movement abilities, and with combination of control abilities, it's just kind of a natural fit. Sarah, this feels like where she belongs the most, and if you've done Surfer decks before, fairly straightforward. It definitely works as a surprise with Surfer instead of Heimdall at the end. People aren't expecting it. And then, of course, as all Silver Surfer decks go, you have a nice amount of counter options with things like Killmonger in the deck. So pretty solid stuff. You can add Wave in the Heimdall package if you want to. Wave being another three-cost card to benefit. And then Heimdall if you want to just get a quick boost to a card like Dagger and Vulture. This is definitely more of a Surfer deck than a move deck, and I still think the regular Surfer deck, the kind of anti-kitty bounce Surfer with Maximus, is probably just as good, but if you want to run Silver Surfer, this would be the deck that I would run with the move option. As you guys know, season after season, Sarah Control is often at the top of the deck list in terms of performance, and I think it's just a matter of time till someone perfects a Miracle move deck. Now, this is going to be my version of the build. I played a good amount of games with it, and it did perform at a very consistent level. Obviously, having Hitmonkey and Jeff, these are going to be harder cards to acquire, and you can definitely replace these with other good value cards like Lizard and other options, even Silk when she comes out. But guys, look at what we got. We have tons of move cards that can get huge in value like Vulture and Dagger. That's going to be a one cost and a two cost card respectively if you have Sarah down. You have the power of Hitmonkey and Mysterio. You can build up Angela throughout the course of the match. And then Enchantress and Shang-Chi to counter, both being three costs. Guys, this thing is pretty crazy. It felt really good. It is pretty damn complex. And again, you have to add this all in with move and add Hitmonkey and Sarah to the deck. There's a lot of moving pieces, but it performs at a very high level once you get the hang of it. And last, but definitely not least, but maybe the hardest, we have move. Bounce. Now, this and the wave decks, I think, are going to be the number one option if you are serious about playing move competitively. These are the two decks that you want to master if you want to be doing conquest or if you want to be climbing dependently up in higher infinite ranks. In my playtesting, not only was bounce move incredibly difficult to play, but also just extremely rewarding. The opponent has no idea what to keep track of. So many moving parts and pieces and combinations that just give you ridiculous value and consistency. Guys, this was already good before Ghost, and she just brings the whole package more together as you have an option to bounce back with Ghost Spider and able to build up these cards so much more dependently. I like Multiple Man and Dagger in the deck a ton. Multiple Man doesn't even need any type of boost up because we have so much else going on. Obviously, Kitty Pryde is huge to get Angela built up. You have Bast as well to build up the hood. I'm sure you could throw in other cards like Iron Man in here if you want to, or even maybe a Darkhawk package. Iceman, Sunspot, Nebula. There's a lot of cards you can add to this deck. Heck, even do a Mysterio and Hitmonkey combo if that floats your boat as well. Move Bounce, I think, is going to be up there in the competitive options, and we're already seeing the stats on this deck. Absolutely ridiculous. I will say you're combining probably arguably the two hardest archetypes in Snap. So like, unless you've played either of them a ton or you're a mathematician, I would learn move first before you play bounce move because of the numbers and the variance. However, once you've kind of mastered it, this is a very strong deck. I'm excited to play this one this season. All right, guys, so there you go. Those are the decks that I think are going to be pretty damn solid altogether. Thank you guys for hanging out and good luck this season. If you enjoyed the video, we're trying to get a plaque for 100,000 subs right there. I might hang it there. I don't know. It's somewhere over here. And I can't wait to hit that goal with you guys. I'm going to start streaming when we get there as well. So if you hang out and you want to support, go ahead and hit the sub button down below. All right, guys, have a good one. Have a great one. Until the next one, happy snapping.